प्रायेण देव मुनयो सविमुक्ति कामा मौनम चरन्ति विजनीन पराथ निष्ठा नैतान विहाय किपनान विमुमुक्षये को नान्यं तदस्य शरणं भ्रमतोऽनुपश्ये प्रायेण देव मुनयो सविमुक्ति कामा मौनम चरन्ति विजनीन परार्थ निष्ठा नैतान विहाय किपनान विमुमुक्षये को नान्यं तदस्य शरणं भ्रमतोऽनुपश्ये
शिशिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद थोल प्रतिष्ठार तरे निर्जन घरे तब हरिनाम केवल कैत्यप हु इज वैष्णव दिस कीर्तन देर प्रभुपाद राइटिंग प्रतिष्ठार तरे निर्जन घरे तब हरिनाम केवल कैत्यप टू गेट प्रतिष्ठा To get Pratishtha, you are doing bhajan, harinam, in a very solitary place. Actually, this is one kind of cheating propensity you have inside you. That's why you are cheated. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, to get Pratishtha, you are doing harinam in a very solitary place to exhibit, to show that, see, I am a big Vaishnava. Point is that Prabhupada already told in this Vaishnava ke there, prana che jara sehetu pachar. I already told this point there in Puri, you can remember, first day. Prana che jara sehetu pachar. What do you mean by pran, life? I already told the vitals of your, life, is that saranagati. Same thing Bhaktivinoda Thakur when discussing, Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Kirtan speaking, Shikhaya saranagati bhakter pran, in Bengali Kirtan. Shikhaya saranagati bhakter pran. Prabhupada speaking, prana che jara sehetu prachar. What do you mean by pran, life? Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving explanation. That sikhaya saranagati bhakter pran. Saranagati is the vital of your bhajan, life of your bhajan. Why I am starting with this point? To glorify the efforts of Prabhupada. Actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking the same thing. Prabhupada asking, that see man, you are going to a solitary place, but be careful. Your mind is there with you. Your material mind is there with you. Material mind following you, because mind is there. Shukshma, fine body, subtle body. So what you can do in a solitary place? There if you go, if you try to do bhajan, all material, material conception, material thinking can come into your mind, can disturb you. Like in cosmic world, you see, in this material world, cosmic world, you can find all the stars and everything there, sun, moon, all stars, they are suspended in space. Who is holding? It is there in suspended. There in galaxy way everywhere. All stars and moon, everything there, countless. Similarly, in your material mind, matters are there in suspended condition. You cannot understand, you can show that where is matter? There is no matter. You see, I am Vairagya, I am a big sadhu. But in fine form, in suspended condition, mind is like space, it can be compared with your material mind. Mind, there are some matters, countless matters there disturbing you. So until and unless you get out of this problem, material disease, you cannot start actually Hari Bhajan. I already told many times. So, Prabhupada speaking, who is the member of Gaudiya Math? Who is the member of Gaudiya Math? Prabhupada speaking, if you find one sadhu, his life is totally dedicated for the Sankirtan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. To satisfy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Sankirtan Pita, he is of course 100% is the member of Gaudiya Math. Otherwise he is not Gaudiya Math. He is not member of Gaudiya Math. Prayena deva munayu sabhi mukti kama mohulam charanti bijanena parartha nishtha. Prahlad Maharaj also speaking same thing. The often we see some sadhu, they are going to a solitary place for his own benefit. He is trying to get control over his sense organ, everything very hard he is trying. He is fighting to get control over sense organ, to master sense organ, then he can concentrate his mind onto the lotus feet of Paramatma, like that. But actually, as per Bhagavad Siddhanta, I already told, this procedure is very easy. Why you are taking trouble? Why you are fighting? Many times I told, Prabhupada speaking, if your whole life is gone to fight with Mayadevi, to cut Mayadevi, when you can start Hari Bhajan? Do you think to fight with Mayadevi is bhajan? You think? No. When you can start Hari Bhajan? If your whole life is gone to fight with Mayadevi, the more you try to get control over Mayadevi, the more you can be in trouble. It's not. This is not the procedure. That's why in Gita Bhagavan saying, Mama Maya Durataya. Mame Bhaja Prapadante Maya Metam Tarantite. Who is inclined to me? Then Maya cannot disturb him anymore. But is it possible to show inclination unto the lotus feet of Krishna directly? Is it possible? In this material condition? Not possible. That's why Prahlad Maharaj, Dhruva Maharaj, they all, Dadas Mahajan, 12 Mahajans, all our Guru Varga, they are coming to us to deliver us. Many times I told this point, you see, it is very easy to get control over Maya. But don't try to fight with Maya. Rajas tamas cha satyena sattan cha pasamena cha etat sarvam guru bhaktya purusha hi anjasayayet. Anjasa means Sanskrit, very easily. Very easily. How? Rajas tamas cha satyena sattan cha upasamena cha etat sarvam guru bhaktya purusha hi anjasayayet. Guru bhaktya means Sadguru. If you can serve one pure devotee, I mean Guru Vaishnava, who is Vaishnava, he is Guru. Bhaktivinoda Thakur's hearing is same tattva. Who is Guru, he is Vaishnava. He is Vaishnava, he is Guru. He is Vaishnava, not Guru, is impossible. Bhaktivinoda Thakur explained. So this way is very easy to get control over Maya if we can serve one pure Vaishnava. Otherwise, you cannot get control. Many sloka there. One by one I can. Even one sloka, that day I was speaking. Naishang mati stavaduru kramanghin sprishyattanarthapagamo yadartho mahi asampadarajo visekam Niskinchananam no brinito yavat. Prahlad Maha speaking the same thing. Prahlad Maha speaking same thing. Until and unless you have the chance to get the dust particle from the lotus feet of pure Vaishnava, you have the chance to put it on your head, to take bath. Many kind of bath. You can sun bath, dust bath, mantra bath, water bath, many kind of. Dibbasnan. Dibbasnan, sunlight is there, so rain drop coming. It's Dibbasnan. Many kind of, you see, in Shastra. So you see, to purify yourself, first of all, you have to serve Guru Vaishnava. Otherwise, you cannot start Hari Bhajan. Prahlad Maharaj is Mahajan. Sayambhur Narado Sambhu Kumar Kapilo Manu. Prahlad Vishmo Janako Vishmo Bolir Vaya Sakir Vayam. 12 Mahajan there. Out of 12 Mahajan, who speaking? Jamraji, Jamraj himself speaking this sloka. That we 12, you know, head Mahajan, knowing Bhagavad Dharma. Why we can worship Prahlad Maharaj? Why we can remember Prahlad Maharaj? One thing is there, if whole Bhagavatam, if I read, at least seventh canto, I can show you that Nrisimha Bhagavan promise in front of us. Nrisimha Bhagavan giving a promise in front of us. Like Nityananda. Nityananda promise. Amare kinya laho vaja gaurahi. And there you can find Nrisimhadev giving a promise in front of us. In front of us. What promise? Nrisimhadev speaking, who can remember you and me? Our relation. He can be free of any material disease. Tvamcha mamcha swarana kale. Tvamcha mamcha swarana kale mukta mandha param bhajet this. Tvamcha mamcha swarana kale karma bandhat pramuchyate. Tvamcha mamcha swarana kale, who can remember you and me, our incident. Tvamcha mamcha swarana kale karma bandhat pramuchyate. Not muchyate. In Sanskrit, some prefix is there in grammar. If you can put that prefix in front of one in front of one word, then its power becomes very high. Muchyate mean free. You can be free. But pramuchyate mean in grammar you can find pro, para, apo, nu, ni, bi. In Sanskrit, special, it can give special power to that word, amplify, like sound. So here you see, pramuchyate, not muchyate. You can be free of any matter, not. Specially you can be free. Specially you can be free of any material disease. It is the commitment, I mean promise, by Nrisimhadev. Prabhupada, in Gauriya society, Prabhupada is a king. Prabhupada king, spiritual hero. Prabhupada wanted to prove that if you can accept the principle of Dadas Mahajan, Dadas Mahajan means 12 Mahajan, and our Guru Varga not Mahajan, What do you mean? Yes, they are also Mahajan. They are Dadas Mahajan, 12th Mahajan, and those who are there under their guidance, they are also Mahajan. Why they are Mahajan? Because they know Bhagavad Dharma. Bhagavad Dharma means Atma Dharma. The Dharma, I mean, which is related to your Atma. Bhagavad Dharma means Atma Dharma. Because these 12 Mahajan, they are having the knowledge of Bhagavad Dharma. Dada Saite Vijanimo. Who? Jamraji Maharaj speaking. After speaking, Sayangur Narado Sambhu Kumaro Kapilo Manu Prahlad Bhismo Janako Bhismo Bolir Vayasakir Bayam Dada Saite Bijanimo Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhata Gujyam Gujyam Vishuddhyam Durvadhyam Yad Gyatya Amritam Asnute. What speaking? Dada Saite Bijanimo. Dada Saite Bijanimo Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhata. Guhyam Vishuddhyam Durvadhyam Yad Gyatya Amritam Asnute. Very careful. Jamraji Maharaj speaking, we 12 have full knowledge about Bhagavad Dharma. Dada Saite Bijanimo Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhata. In front of his servant, in relation to Ajamil Prasanga is coming, you see. When his servant, I mean, they are going to arrest Ajamil, and they come back, they are not successful to bring Ajamil, then Jamraji Maharaj giving advice. Oh, my servant, be careful. Dada Saite Bijanimo Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhata. It's very secret. Gujyam, Gujyam is very, very secret. Most secret. Gujyam, Vishuddhyam, most pure. Vishuddhyam, not Suddham, most pure. Gujyam, Vishuddhyam, Durvodhyam. It is very complicated. Out of human comprehension, beyond comprehension. Human comprehension. Only by the mercy of Mahajan, you can have realization power. You can memorize whole scripture. You can prove in front of this society, I am a big pandit, but still what it concerns to us. You cannot come out successful. The Dadas Mahajan, still today, under the guidance of Prabhupada, we worship Dadas Mahajan. You know, at the time of Yajna, we put 12 pots in prasadam, everything. At the time of Yajna, you know, when your this cart thread, then Yajna, then 12 pots we put. There we offer respective prasadam for 12 Mahajan each. You can remember? You cannot remember? Eh? You should remember every time sacrifice going on, fire sacrifice in temple, you can find. So now point is that Prabhupada want to prove the same thing. What? Though we know, what is our ultimate goal? What is we go here, what is our ultimate goal? What is our ultimate goal? To understand the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Manjari Bhava. Be careful. It is the ultimate goal, supreme goal. To understand the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Every time, each and every action, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to prove. Nija bhajana mudram padisham. The secrecy, I mean, of bhajan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to proof in his own life. So that all followers, they can understand very easily, come on man, this is bhajan. But that doesn't mean we can throw Prahlad Maharaj. That doesn't mean we can throw Dhruva Maharaj. That doesn't mean we can throw all Mahajan. Not there. That is why when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doing Leela in Nirachand Dham, many times Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to Gadadhar Pandit, they are in Tota Gopinath, you know. There are many times Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going and asking Gadadhar, today I like to hear Prahlad Maharaj's Nishingadev Prasanga. I mean, this topic I like to hear. Prabhu, 2 months ago I already read this. Well, I know, but still I like to hear. I like to hear Dhruva Maharaj Prasanga, relation, topics. Can you discuss this point so that I can hear it? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, Supreme Authority. You want to show us how to go bumper circles, success, gradually, slow but steady, win the race. First of all, you don't have any control over your sense organ, nothing, you have no saranagati. How you can go up to Manjari level? Is possible? Not possible. So there you see, Prabhupada wanted to prove, don't go to solitary bhajan. You will have to do sankirtan from heart in front of thousands of people. Don't go to solitary bhajan. You stay in front of our Vaishnava. Then you can rectify yourself. If you stay in front of a pure Vaishnava, you have the chance how they are doing. Of course, if you do aparad, then you have the chance to fall down. This is also there. I told you that if you like to come out successful this life, then you will have to serve a pure Vaishnava. You will have to sell your head unto the lotus feet of a pure Vaishnava. And if you like to go to hell very quickly, still it is the procedure. If you can serve a pure Vaishnava, then you can do aparad and go to hell very quickly. Very quick procedure. Very quickly you can go. So be careful. So, you see, Prabhupada speaking, in front of Guru Vaishnava, you can stay in front of devotees, you can go on doing Sankirtan. Because in Siva Sangam, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibit this Sankirtan Yajna, enlight. Sankirtan, that Sankirtan Yajna, this fire is still going on in the line of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Bhakti Vinod Dara. Now we go back to teachings of Prahlad Maharaj. First point, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, same thing as Prabhupada speaking. We have the chance to take some teachings from Prahlad Maharaj to understand Gaudiya Bhajan. Prayena deva munayo sabimukti kama maunam charanti vijane na parasen. They are going there in solitary place to do bhajan for their own benefit. But Prahlad Maharaj saying, oh Prabhu Nisingadev, I am not so selfish. I am not so selfish, so that I can seek only my own benefit. If you really love me, if you really coming in front of me to give kripa, then you will have to bestow kripa on those asur balakas, those asur boys in front of me, they are all my friends. They are all my friends, you see. Now they have the chance to get your kripa. And without you, who can show mercy to them? Because you are most merciful, you see. So if you like to give kripa to me only, then I don't. If you like to give kripa, then you have to give kripa to all asur balakas, asur boys. It is very easy for you. You can do anything you like. So you'll have to do kripa to them. So that they can understand Bhagavad Dharma. They can they can go out of this material desire. So we'll have to do kipa. Now next point, Gaudiya Siddhanta, Bhagavata Siddhanta, same thing. Bhagavata Siddhanta with Prahlad Maharaj Siddhanta, same. That just slok, one slok I was speaking. If you have the chance to take dust particle from the lotus feet of a pure Vaishnava, then you can rectify your brain. Otherwise, you cannot rectify your brain. Now, the father of Prahlad Maharaj is Hiranyakasipu. Is it true? A father of Prahlad Maharaj is Hiranyakasipu. How is that possible? Tameva mata cha pita tameva. Then, who is father, who is mother? Hiranyakasipu, father of Prahlad Maharaj? Yes, he is father. Materially it's true. In material planet. In material planet it is, have some relation. So, Hiranyakasipu. Then Prabhupada explaining, what do you mean by Hiranyakasipu? Hiranya in Sanskrit word is mean the gold. I mean, and Kasipu mean, Kasipu mean nice bed. I mean, it implies that Kamini Kanchan. Simply, Kamini and Kanchan. It means Hiranyakasipu. So Hiranyakasipu is the embodiment of Kamini Kanchan, fully. Always want Kamini and Kanchan to get, you want to get control over this material world, 14 world. Hey, you must be under my guidance, control. Popa speaking, those who like to get control over this material world, their bondage is very strong. Those who want to get control over this material world, their bondage is very strong. Understand? So very big problem. Now that point is that Hiranyakasipu going to do SCT and finances, you know. In short I can speak, in short compares. Very short. Hiranyakasipu going to do SCT and finances there in forest to get power. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking same thing in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Do you think SCT and finances and any kind of you know, tapasya you are doing, it can satisfy me? Do you think so? No. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself speaking. Asuro tap kare tahe kiba phal, tahe kiba la. Asur, those who are demon, they are also going for city and finance. What it concerned to me? It is not bhakti. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Asuro tap kare tahe kiba phal. Those who are asur, they are also doing tap. Sometimes you can find those who are demonic character, they can also quote some point from scripture. How you can understand? Hiranyakasipu, when giving consolation to the wife of his younger brother, then he was speaking something from scripture. Oh mother, be careful. In this material world, nothing is permanent. Hiranyakasipu is speaking. But at the same time, Hiranyakasipu is going to collect Kamini Kancha. He is giving advice. His character and speech, not tally. He is speaking, giving nice advice to mother, Ambo, Ambo. In material world, nothing is permanent. So my younger brother gone, your son is gone, so what problem? So he is also quoting something from scripture. So devils can also quote scripture. Devils can sometimes quote scripture. But be careful, who is devil, who is wrong. If you are confused, then you cannot come outside. In the name of satsanga, you can go to hell. Satsanga is not so easy. Not that you have money power, so you can arrange one satsanga. Not that. If you think you have money power, so I can arrange satsanga. No. It is not siddhanta. Satsanga prapate pungvir bahuvir sukriti purva sanchitai. Tulsidas speaking. Binu satsanga taraina koi. Ram kipa binu sulab na sui. Without the kipa of Ram, you cannot get satsanga. So Hiranyakashipu gone in forest, Mandarachal Parvat, to do astringent penance. Is it bhakti? No, to get power. It is not bhakti. Now we like to get blessings from Brahma, the creator. Brahma already come. So we can take benediction from Brahma. So that no, I can be amar, immortal. Eh? No, you cannot get that kind of benediction. I cannot give. Other benediction you can get. No, I like this. Then Brahma gone. Again started. That kind of ascetic penances is rare in this universe. Brahma speaking, the kind of ascetic penances you are exhibiting, it is rare. Not almost rare, it is rare. Brahma speaking. But still it is not bhakti. Brahma speaking. Na bhutam na bhavishvati. Na bhutam na bhavishvati. The kind of astrology and penances you exhibit in your life, in future nobody can show. In past nobody could show. Not possible. What about present time? But still it is not bhakti. So this way, now Prahlad Maharaj was there inside the womb of mother. When Hiranyakashipu gone to Mandarachal Parvat, that time Prahlad Maharaj there inside the womb of mother. Now Indra Maharaj coming to arrest Kayadhu, the wife of Hiranyakashipu. Hey, come on. She is crying. Why you are arresting me? No, I can take you in my place. Then suddenly Naradji coming, appear. Naradji speaking, oh Indra Maharaj, oh king, what you are doing? Muncha muncha paraparigraham. She is the wife of Hiranyakashipu, you should not touch her. Indra Maharaj says, well, I know. But I am arresting her to keep in my custody. Why? Because inside his womb, there is one asur. If she can give birth, I can kill that asur, then I can let her free. I can allow that lady to go. Naraji Maharaj said, you gone mad? No! No asur is there! Asur is there inside? No! It is Bhagavad Bhakta. Big Mahabhagavad there inside. You really? Mahabhagavad there. Whole universe can get benefit from him. You can see in future. So leave. Okay. As you order. Then doing parikrama, kayadu, 4 times parikrama. Then leave, kayadu, go.
You cannot kill him also.
Now point is that Naraji Maharaj taking that lady, I mean mother, Prahlad Maharaj, to his own ashram. She is crying, please save me, oh Naraji, don't let me go, because somebody can kill me. Naraji blessing him, no problem, you stay in this ashram, I bless you. And the choir do asking one special benediction that when my husband can come back, then I can give birth to that baby. Well, then Naraji Maharaj giving advice, I mean Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. Naraji Maharaj giving advice, Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan to Kayadhu. You can test in your own life. Any Mataji can test in his own life. When she can hear Bhagavat Katha, Bhagavat Vigyan, Gita, then she can give birth to a very nice boy. From the very beginning, there is some procedure as per scripture. A very secret procedure in that. Right from the beginning, nobody knows this point. Nobody knows. It's a very secret point. Right from the beginning. Then mother can give birth to a very nice boy, a girl. But nobody knows. Then now, actually, point is that Naraji Maharaj giving blessing. She is there, hearing Bhagavad Katha, everything, Harikathas, everyday Kirtan and Harikatha. But actually, Kayadhu very fickle-minded. A mind is, she has no stability of mind. Always thinking anxiety and always anxiety inside. So Naraji giving advice, but she cannot catch it. When Guru Vaishnav giving us advice, giving Harikatha, then if I have the capacity to catch, that is good. How to develop capacity? If somebody asking me how to develop capacity to catch the speech of Guru Vaishnava, advice of Guru Vaishnava. First point, seva. I mean, basic point is brahmacharya. Brahmacharya is the basic point. For a long time, if you observe brahmacharya, gradually you can feel some power. And dry brahmacharya, I don't mean dry brahmacharya. To serve Guruji, it means brahmacharya. To serve Guruji is automatically it means brahmacharya. Without brahmacharya, how can you serve a pure devotee? So it's an automatic factor. So there we see, to serve a pure Vaishnava, to observe brahmacharya, gradually if you go on doing long time, then you can develop a special power. Some power can emit from your body. Those who are maintaining brahmacharya, you can watch. That those who are observing brahmacharya guru seva, you can feel some power coming from their body. Some sort of power emitting. And they can catch your mind at a time. Your mind cannot go anywhere. Then you can 100% be sure that he is following brahmacharya and guru seva. 100%. And one materially one big pandit is speaking, but your mind is going here, you cannot get any kind of speech, I mean stability. He's speaking nicely, but it cannot give any impression into your heart. Then be sure he is not observing brahmacharya. It's very, very secret topics. Now, actually, Prahlad Maharaj is there inside the womb of Kayadhu. So, those Harikatha, Naraji speaking, actually, Prahlad Maharaj hearing Harikatha. Kayadhu, the mother hearing, was okay. But mother, due to instability of mind, cannot catch this. But Prahlad Maharaj, right from the beginning, he is brahmacharya. Special. Yes. So Prahlad Maharaj hearing all advice from Naraji Maharaj. So you know. So Naraji Maharaj is the actual guru of Prahlad Maharaj. Naraji Maharaj is the actual guru of Prahlad Maharaj. Because if you have the chance to hear Bhagavad Katha, I mean Tattva Siddhanta, Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan from any super personality, Guru Vaishnav, then he is your guru. Then the actual guru of Prahlad Maharaj is Naraji, right from the beginning. Now Hiranyakashipu coming back, because Hiranyakashipu wanted to receive some special benediction from Brahma. When Brahma not at all ready to give that kind of special benediction, then Hiranyakashipu wanted to make fool of Brahma. Okay, you need not give that kind of benediction. You can only speak. You can only promise me, give me benediction that not in the evening time and morning time nobody can kill me. Any time nobody can kill me. Not evening, morning, night, nobody. And nobody can kill me in land or space. Nobody. This way. Not by any weapon, not by any weapon, nobody can kill me by weapon. No animal, no man, nobody in this universe can kill me. This way, Hiranyakashipu wanted to make fool of Brahmaji, because Brahmaji is old man. I can make fool of Brahmaji. He is old man. So, Naraji, Hiranyakashipu wanted to make fool of Brahmaji. Well, after that coming back, now having some special power, big power, he is trying to get control over 14 worlds. Everybody should hear me. Now, Prahlad Maharaj took birth. After that, Hiranyakashipu taking special care about his education. So one asur, what kind of special care can an asur take about the education of his? He can do arrange education like his own conception. Material. So material education he like to give to. Economics, he like to teach economics so that he can get money and money, more money. Economics. And political judgment, he like to give teaching special, political judgment, everything. So this way, Hiranyakashipu arranged a special teaching for his own son, Prahlad Maharaj, where he sent Prahlad Maharaj, Sando and Amarko, two sons of Sukracharya. The son of Sukracharya too. Sando and Amarko, two sons. And Sukracharya, this word, a special word. Nobody knows. Prabhupada explaining this one. Like Dakshya, this word has some special meaning. Dakha Pujapati, you know? Big firing Siva and Dakha. So Dakha, this name also special name. Why is having this kind of special name? Daksha? Daksha means efficient. Daksha means efficient. What do you mean by efficiency? Material efficiency he has. Material efficiency. He is very efficient to get control over this management of this material world. How to get money, how to get kamini, kanchan. He is very learned man about this. So you see, his name is Dakha. And Sukracharya means, Sukracharya is a special name. And Sukra, his material birth. He can give birth to material person, Sukracharya, material thing, Sukracharya. You don't understand. I will have to explain more and more, but the time is very limited. So many things. So Shukracharya can give birth to material things. Even Shukracharya can give initiation to anything, he can give birth to a not spiritual personality, material personality. Follow my point. Very secret point. Though Shukracharya, many demons, they are initiated by Shukracharya. But they cannot get any spiritual benefit. Shukracharya can give birth to material personality. By taking initiation from Shukracharya, they can develop their material conception. Oh, we are big asura. Not any spiritual benefit. That's why his name is Shukracharya. Now, Sandhya and Amarka, they are two teachers. And in the race of those demons, all Asurabhayas, they are going to their school to get special teaching from Sandhya Amarka and Shukracharya. Now, Prahlad Maharaj is a small boy. He sent there. Now, Prahlad Maharaj is very clever. Prahlad Maharaj sitting in front of Sandhya and Amarka, two teachers. Hey, try to memorize this point. Try to recite. The yesterday I speak, now you speak. You can remember? Prahlad Maharaj, very careful. Always trying humble attitude in front of all seniorly person. Never strike. Always humble attitude, Prahlad Maharaj. Yes. Whatever they are giving, any kind of teaching they are, Prahlad Maharaj hearing at least, though from heart, Prahlad Maharaj is not going to accept it. But material in front of them, what to speak? From heart, Prahlad Maharaj is not going to accept that kind of teaching. But still what to do? I am sent by my father to this, in this school, so I must submit artificially here. So hearing on material thing. Then after Sandhya Amarka, by chance going to some other seva, I mean seva mean material work, not seva. Seva this word I cannot use. Seva this term I can only use in the case of Guru, Vaishnav, Dham, Nam, I can. Be careful. Any word I use, I become very careful. Seva this term in material people same. They are doing seva for elephant. They are doing seva for horse. Poorly speaking, they are all foolish people. They are doing seva for poor people. But this is not seva. Some benefit, material benefit you are doing. Seva, you cannot speak this seva. Seva is only applicable in the case of Guru, Vaishnav, Dham, Nam, Bhagavan, is seva. Seva, this word is not fancifully, you cannot use it. Like Jayanti, Gaur Jayanti, Krishna Jayanti, Rabindra Jayanti, they are speaking Rabindra Jayanti, Nojrul Jayanti. But foolish people. Rabindra Jayanti, how possible? Jayanti, this word you cannot use, but material people, they are using it. Jayanti, this word you cannot use. Jayanti mean you can develop the power to cut this material bondage and go up a spiritual planet. So they are using this term in newspaper everywhere. Rabindra Jayanti, Nojrul Jayanti, they are using. So what we can fight? The Jayanti is what you cannot use it. Only in case of Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, you can use this word, Jai. Now, actually, Prahlad Maharaj externally getting some teaching from Sandhya Amarka. Now, suppose they are going to some material work outside, then Prahlad Maharaj now have the chance to preach Bhagavad Dharma in school. So many boys there, they are all friends. Oh, my friends, come and sit. Now Prahlad Maharaj have the chance to speak, to preach Bhagavad Dharma. All those Surabaya, they are sitting around Prahlad Maharaj and speaking nice Bhagavad Katha. Teaching to them. Now those boys, they are wearing surprise. You see, Prahlad, you and all of us, we are getting same teaching from this teacher. This is Sandamarko. Then how you can have the chance to get this kind of special teachings you are giving to us? How? Then Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Actually, this teaching coming from my Gurudev Naraji, not from here. I am not getting teaching from. He is material teacher. I cannot accept material teachings from. I can accept material teaching externally, but internally, my teacher is actually Naraji. So my teacher is Guruji, Naraji. I heard so many Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, science. So I can speak all in front of you. Yeah. When my father went to Mandarachal, then he is speaking all previous incident. Now I got this kind of teaching from Naraji Maharaj. Now Prahlad Maharaj speaking first teaching. Komare achare dharmo pragyan bhagavata nihu. Those boys asking, we are no boy. We are very small boy. We don't have any conception about what is dharma, what is adharma. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, see, Bhagavad Dharma is related to your Atma, heart. So in born he have the scope to hear it. In born. So you cannot say this way that now I am 5 years boy, now I am 6 years boy. You cannot speak that way. Any age, irrespective of any age, you can practice this dharma. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, irrespective of any age factor, you can learn this dharma. Very careful. You can learn this dharma. Now, this way, Prahlad Maharaj giving a nice teaching in front of those Asura boys. With enthusiastic mood they are learning. But somehow this news going to Hiranyakasipu gone before. Hiranyakasipu. And Sandhya and Amarko, they are very anxious. How is that possible that he developed that kind of pure knowledge? I never impart that kind of knowledge to them. Hey Prahlad, how you are getting this kind of knowledge? I never teach you. How you get? They are very conscious. Then they like to take Prahlad Maharaj in front of Hiranyakasipu, in front of Hiranyakasipu to show what kind of teaching we are giving to him solo. Now Hiranyakasipu, like a small boy, taking a lap, kissing him, getting smell on his head, blessing, oh my boy, you are getting teachings from your Gurudev, huh? What kind of teaching you learned from your Gurudev? Can you speak any kind of special question if I put in front of Prahlad, then he can become, get nervous. So, open question. What kind of teaching you got from your Gurudev? And Prahlad Maharaj thought, my father asking from Gurudev, what kind of teaching you are getting? what kind of teaching I am getting from my Gurudev. My father means my Gurudev is Sandana Marko. But anyway, he is speaking from your Gurudev, what kind of teaching you speak? But my actual Gurudev is Naraji. So I can disclose this point. I am getting this special teachings from my Gurudev Naraji. My father means my Gurudev is Sandana Marko. But anyway, he is speaking from your Gurudev, what you learn. So what kind of teachings you got? Then Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Banam Gatahayad Harimasrayat. Potam Sloka starting taki. What is the starting you can remember? I forget. Many times I speak. Actually, Banam Gatahayad Harimasrayat. Prahlad Maharaj speaking that this in this material world, you are in always you are getting some kind of anxiety. Always in this material world, you are always getting some sort of anxiety. So if you can leave and go to forest, if you have the chance to take shelter unto the lotus feet of Hari, then I think it is called actual teachings. Banam gatahayat harimas rayid. If you can go to forest and take shelter unto the lotus feet of Hari. Hari mean Vishnu. Then I think it is called actual teaching. Now Hiranyaka become very anxious. Hey, what kind of teaching you are giving to my boy? He is speaking about bhakti. Then Sandana Marko becoming very frightened. Believe me, believe us. Believe us, King, we never give that kind of teaching. We never give that kind of teaching. How he is getting that kind of teaching, we don't know. In our ashram, nobody can come and go because it's a very secret place. Those boys, they are staying very exclusively. There is no chance that outside people can come and give this kind of teachings to them. How they are getting that kind of thing? We cannot speak. Naishargiki iyam matirasa rajan. Naishargiki iyam matirasa rajan. He rajan asamati. His mind is naturally it is like that. How is that possible? Believe us. Naishargiki iyam matirasa rajan. Hey Rajan, hey King, this kind of teaching, where from he is getting, we don't know. But we notice, we very carefully we watch, it is coming from heart, the heart of Prahlad Maharaj. Naishargiki, naturally it is coming from heart. Naturally it is coming from heart. Then Hiranyakasipu become very angry. Then again taking permission, can you allow us, give a chance more? Well, now take my boy. Again going back to ashram. They also, they are giving teaching anything. They are giving teaching. Then in ashram, there is a Sandamarka asks him, where from you, my son, where from you getting this kind of teaching? Then Prahlad Maharaj speaking. This kind of bhakti, by material effort, you cannot get that kind of bhakti. Nate vidu sartha gotim hi vishnu dura sayaje bahirarthaman andha yathandhair upaniyaman steyo pisichatanta murudam nibadhya nate vidu sartha gotim hi vishnu dura sayaje bahirarthaman अंधायथंधरूपनीयमानं तेयो पिशिचतांत मुरुदां निबाध्या. प्रह्लाद महाराज स्पीकिंग नाते विदु सार्थ गति में विष्णु जो हिरण्यकशिपु व्हेन आस्किंग हु गिव यू दिस काइंड ऑफ टीचिंग नाते विदु स्वार्थ गति में विष्णु. The teacher, you engage some teacher for me, but they are not having that kind of special knowledge. So how they can teach me? Not a vidu swartha gatim hi vishnu. Even they don't know the secrecy of Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. They don't know that Vishnu is the ultimate interest of our life. Vishnu Seva is the ultimate interest of all life. Ultimate interest to serve Vishnu, I mean Krishna. But they don't know. Nate vidu swartha gati mi Vishnu. Swartho, if I can translate the word into English, it becomes self, means self-interest. It becomes self-interest. But what do you mean by self? What do you mean by interest? Self means Atma inside you. Follow my boy. So self means Atma inside you, and interest related to the Atma is self interest. But material people say you are very selfish. I mean you are very materially. He always try to control his own interest. Material people think that we are trying to get control over this material thing, so people can say you are very selfish. So selfish is this word, they don't understand the actual meaning. Self means Atma, and interest, any interest related to that Atma is called self interest. Na te vidu swartha gatim hi vishnu dura sayaje bahirarthamanim. Their mind is going outside world. Their mind is channelized toward this material world. You have seen State Bank logo? You have seen State Bank logo? One round and then one channel. What do you mean? State Bank logo. You have seen? Don't see? Yeah, you can see State Bank. One round. Then after that you can get one channel. All economical development can be die if you can put all money and can you have the chance to channelize it proper channel, then you can come out economically success. It means follow. I have some logo, State Bank logo. One round. After that some channel is there. Then it is. That means. All money, you should not waste money. You can put all money for the development of country. Follow? So material people, their all material mind is channelized towards this material world. They are always thinking about material interest, how to develop interest, how to get material interest. They are always thinking. So this way, they are actually deprived. They are actually cheated. They think we are very clever. There is four kind of cheating propensity. One is four kind of self cheating propensity. Vipralamba. There. is one kind of cheating purpose. So now you know, their mind is always going to material world. So their mind, never they can touch that transcendental one. Never they can. Naitat mano me. Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of Nrisimhadeva, I can speak after. This my material mind cannot touch Vaikuntha Jagat. Already Prahlad Maharaj told, Naishangmati stavadu kramang spisati. Already Prahlad Maharaj told, now you can find in front of Nrisimhadeva, Prahlad Maharaj giving so nice thing. Naitat mano me. Naitat mano me. This my material mind cannot touch the Vaikuntha Jagat. Cannot touch. Big problem. So now, here in this sloka, the sloka I was explaining, there actually Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Nate vidu swartha gatim hi Vishnu. Dura sayaje bahirarthamanin. Their material conception is very contaminated. Their mind is very contaminated. So they cannot touch. That Vaikuntha Jagat. So how you can expect they can give me that kind of teaching? Not possible. Second time, Hiranyakasipu meeting his boy. I mean, actually it's four boys. Prahlad Maharaj, I think, second boy or third, I can. Prahlad, Sanghalad, this way, three, four songs, Hiranyakasipu. Allad, Sanghalad, Prahlad, this way, four songs, three or four songs. Now, actually, second time when Sandhya Namarko being sung, they are coming with the song. Now, Hiranyakasipu sitting in throne, Singhasan, hear your song. You can test him what kind of teaching we are giving to them so long. Then Hiranyakasipu again, in lap, kissing, now asking. Tat sadh manneh asura varja dehinam sada samud vigna diya masad graha hitva tupatam grihamand kupam banam gata yad harima srayid. First time question. Second time I can discuss now. Tat sadh manneh. What Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of Hiranyakasipu? Tat sadh manneh asura varja dehinam sada samud vigna dhiya masad grahat hitva tupatam grihamand kupam banam gata yad harima srayet. Hiranyakasipu asking, what kind of teaching you think fit, what you receive from your guru? Then Hiranyakasipu in front of Hiranyakasipu, Prahlad Maharaj with appealing mood. Prahlad Maharaj is very humble. Bhagavad Bhakta is always humble. Tat sadhu manneh asura varja dehinam sada samud bhigna dhiya masad gruhat hitva tupatam grihamanda kupam banam gata hayad harimasrayet. Prahlad Maharaj is not saying this way, oh my father, don't speak. Be careful, Prahlad Maharaj, each and every word, very scientific. Prahlad Maharaj not speaking, oh my father, not this way. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, tat sadhu manne he asura varja dehinam. Asura varja means, in asura race, in old asura destiny, you are the topmost asura. Number one, You are number one asura. Hiranyakashipu was saying, oh, he is giving big honor to me. Ah! But as far as spiritual description, Prahlad Maharaj unveiling the truth in front of us, what kind of etiquette, what kind of character is there with my father. He never speak, oh my father. Tat sadhu manneha asura varja dehi nam, he topmost asura. In the asura destiny, I think it is good. Tat sadhu manne, he asura varja dehi nam for the material people. Because they are put into material world always, and material tension. They are always getting some sort of tension. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, he asura varja dehi nam, sada samudvigno diya masad gruhat. When bad star influencing you, then Saturn begin me in problem, Maharaj, all my money gone. Eh? Eh? You are speaking this way? Uranus, Neptune, eh, Maharaj is very star, all bad, bad position. You must take stone to rectify your position. Prahlad Maharaj is speaking this way. You go to astrologer, oh, Neptune is very bad. You will have to take this. What to do? Saturn is also very bad. This way he give one prescription, you will have to spend at least 50,000 rupees. But you are not following the easiest procedure to do bhakti. My Guru Maharaj used to laugh when Guru Maharaj see one costly stone in hand. Is playing Dandavat, my son, you don't believe Krishna, why Maharaj? You are having stone, oh, you are getting this stone, you don't believe Krishna? Krishna can control the infinity world, you cannot, he cannot control you. In Mangalacharan, we can see from Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, you can see Krishna Uchara Matrena, Vishnu Uchara Matrena. Krishna so smarana deva sakala vignani nasyanti nasangsayo. In Mangalacharan, when you think about Vishnu, when you see Krishna, all amangal vanish, but you don't believe. That's why you go to an astrologer. Then what I can do? Huh? Nine kind of star always influencing you, but we are very sorry, 10th star Krishna not controlling us. Eh? The 10th star, the strongest star is Krishna. He cannot control you. You don't believe Krishna. That's why. Tatsandhu manne he asurvaja dehinam sada samudvigna diya masad gruhat. Like bad star giving influence on material people, they are in danger. Venus, very bad. Then, Prahlad Maharaj saying, Tat sadhu manneha asura varja dehi nam, for material people is dangerous when the star, material star, they putting influence on them. Then, sada samudvigna diya masad grahad, Hitvattupatam, attupatam is suicidal. If you are staying in material family life, if you are leading material family life, suppose if you are leading materially, then it is called suicidal squad. Hitvattupatam, attupatam means suicidal squad. You want to kill yourself. Suicide. Prahladma speaking. Those people, they are leading material life, I mean family life. They are actually, it is one kind of suicidal squad. So I suggest my father, I think it is good if they leave this material world and go to forest. If they leave this material world and go to forest. I think it is good if they leave this material world and go to forest and do Hari Bhajan. I think it's good. The when Prahlad Maharaj speaking this way because come on, he is Dadas Mahajan, one of the 12th Mahajan. Why Prahlad Maharaj speaking this way? Banam gatahayad harina, banam gatahayad harima strayad. If Prahlad Maharaj suggesting me to go to forest and Prahlad Maharaj speaking this way and Prabhupada speaking, why you are going to forest? Then it's contradiction. There's no Siddhanta. What does it mean? Prahlad Maharaj speaking, banam gatahayad harima strayad. But Prabhupada speaking, why you are going to forest? Then there is contradiction. He is Mahajan, he is Mahajan. Nobody is speaking lie. Then how Siddhanta we can reconcile? Then from Bhagavatam you can find Uddhava, to Uddhava Krishna giving advice. What do you mean by forest? Banam tu sattikam basam rajasam gram uchate. Tamasam duta sadhanam. Antannikatanam tu nirgunam. Actually, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving advice to Uddhava. Uddhava, what do you mean by forest? Ban? Banam gatahaya harimasraya Prahlad Maharaj speaking. So do you think Prahlad Maharaj advising us to go to forest? No. This way, Krishna Bhagavan giving explanation, banam tu sattikam basam. Ban mean to go to forest, mean to stay with all sadhu and hear harikatha. That is called banavas. Banam tu sattikam basam. If you stay with all sadhu around you, you have the chance to hear harikatha. Then you are in forest. I mean, no material thing can touch you. Banam tu sattikam basam. Rajasam grama uchyate. Rajas. Rajas bhat. Sattik bhat. Rajas bhat mean to stay materially in village. Banam tu sattikam basam. Rajasam grama uchyate. Gram mani material thing. Gramma katha. Mahaprabhu speaking na? Gramma katha na koi be gramma varta na suni be gramma katha na. Mahaprabhu giving advice to Raghunath? So gramma varta mean material discussion. Don't try to hear any material discussion. Don't speak anything material. Siddhanti Maharaj, you can Siddhanti Maharaj is a disciple of Prabhupada. They are in Navadvip, and you can go to Kolkata Mat also. You can find some picture of monkey. You can see one monkey this way, one monkey this way, one monkey this way. What does it mean? Don't see bad, don't hear bad, don't speak bad. One monkey here, one monkey. This is a exhibition, nice. Don't speak bad, don't hear bad, don't look bad, don't smell bad, nothing. This way all monkey exhibiting one this way monkey. So you see, banam tu sattikam basam. If you stay amidst, with sadhus, you can stay. Then it's called Satyagvasa. You have the chance to hear Harikatha. No material thing can touch you. Banam tu sattikam basam. Rajasam gramauchate. If you stay with material conception, a material word, material thing, then it's called Gramvas. And tamasam duto sadhanam. Tamas bas means gambling. All useless thing. Agyan. It's called what? Tamabas. Anmanniketanam tu nirganam. Krishna speaking, if you stay in my temple from heart, many people staying in temple but they are in tamaguna. Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if you try to make a building, if you try to build up a temple, if you set up a nice temple, if you arrange, there are some material people coming, there are rajasic tamasic people, or rajogun and tamogun, they are influenced by rajogun and tamogun, they are staying in temple, then no benefit can, no outside people cannot get any benefit out of that. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. If there is no sadhu, some people staying, those who are having some rajogun, tamogun, then Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, from this kind of temple, we cannot expect any kind of mangal, benefit. Because all rajogun people stay. Outside people can come and spit on us. Thu! You are doing your character is this way? Can speak? Nobody want to play head over this issue. Whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur many times crying on this issue. Those who are having power to get control over temple and this, they should be very careful about this point. Otherwise, in near future, we are going to lose spiritual benefit, I mean, spiritual flow. Very careful. So, Banam to Sattika Mahaja, everybody, everything done. So, first, when Hiranyakasipu asking to Prahlad Maharaj, then Tatsad Manni Asura Varja Dehinam Sada Samad Vigna Diya Masad Gruhat Itva Tupatam Gyamanda Kupam Banam Gata Yad Banam Gata Yad Harima Asrayet. If you can take shelter onto the lotus feet of Hari, I think it's good. This way. Now, Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of, this in front of Hiranyakasipu speaking. Second time when Prahlad Maharaj, they bring Prahlad Maharaj, then second time what Prahlad Maharaj say? Navavidha Bhakti. Sravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnaha Svaranam, Archanam, Bandhyanam, Shaksham, Dasyam, Shaksham Atma Nivedanam. Iti punsa said bhakti navalakshana navalakshana nine folds of bhakti e bhakti schet navalakshana kriyete bhavagati adhya tanmande adhitamatyamam nine folds of bhakti. If anybody can develop that kind of bhakti, Suravarya, I think this is the best teaching that a jivatma can receive in this material world. Then Hiranyakasipu become fire. How dare you speak that way? Can kill you. Hiranyakasipu become very angry. Then throw the boy from Singhasan. Now so long he was kissing. And after advising about Navavidha Bhakti, ninefold of Bhakti, taking the boy and throw. Prahlad Maharaj. He throw Prahlad Maharaj, a small boy. And after that, still Prahlad Maharaj is not annoyed. Very cool. Where from you get that kind of teaching? How dare you speak like that? In 14 world, everybody become very careful in front of me. Whereas you are speaking like a foolish in front of you. Where from you get power to speak in front of me? Prahlad Maharaj speaking, I am getting power from the supreme authority. You are also getting power from that supreme authority. Stop! Don't speak that way. You are also getting power from that supreme authority. I am also getting power from the supreme. This way we are doing God. Stop! Don't speak that way. I can kill you. Well, he get the sword out. I can cut your throat and throw. Let me see who can save you. You are always speaking big, big. You are tall talk. Yeah? Let me see who can save you. Who is there? Let me see. Where is your? Who can save you? Prahlad Maharaj speaking. It is there everywhere. Also, he is there inside your heart. He is there inside my heart. Everywhere? Then why I cannot see? Hiranyakashipu, material conception, he likes to see the Supreme Lord by these eyes. Those who are material people, they have that kind of desire to see Krishna, to see Guru Vaishnava. Well, I know that Vaishnava very good. Don't explain in front of me. So this way, we are Hiranyakashipu. We know that Vaishnava. Don't speak that way. So we can understand. Whereas material people cannot know Guru Vaishnava, they cannot understand who is Krishna. Eh? Can? Not possible. But Sarge, the demigods, they also cannot understand Vaishnaver Kriya Mudra Vigyena Bujhoi. Vaishnaver Kriya Mudra Vigyena Bujhoi. Vaishnaver Kriya Mudra Vigyena Bujhoi. Even demigods, they cannot understand who is Vaishnava, who is not. Only one pure Vaishnava can understand. He is Vaishnava. His activities, Siddhanta, Acharan, they can understand. He is pure Vaishnava. It is not the question of advertisement that I am big Vaishnava. Then Prahlad Maharaj speaking, why I cannot see? If he is everywhere, why I cannot see? Prahlad Maharaj speaking, he is staying everywhere, omnipresent. And can I see him inside this thumb, I mean pillar? Can I see inside this pillar? Your Prabhu, your Bhagavan, your Krishna is there? Yes, he is also there. He is also there. Well, he is there. Then he feast, a big feast on that pillar. Gum. Then the pillar becomes smashed. And from inside pillar, Hiranyakashipu coming out of that pillar. Hiranyakashipu coming. He a big feast. Then the pillar smashed. After that, Hiranyakashipu look, what is that? This big light, like sunlight, big thousands of sunlight at a time. We see some light, big power. And inside that we see some animal there. Ah, lion. What is it? He cannot see properly. Then Hiranyakashipu want to watch very carefully. After that, he is opening his sword. He is saying some creature is there inside this fire. I mean light. Let me kill him. He likes to fight with Hiranyakashipu. The Hiranyakashipu also making joking with him. Sometime here, sometime here. Sometime you see, like you see. Sometime we see, and sometime you see a snake. You see, catching one rat, and then again leave. The snake going again catch, again leave. You know. Playing. Sometimes the snake they are playing with rat. Sometimes go. Then again catch. Then again go. This way, then Hiranyakashipu, you see, Hiranyakashipu cannot understand what is this. What do we see inside that light? Then anyway, I must fight. I must kill. And after this fighting going on, big fighting. Sometimes Santai Nishingadev catching Hiranyakashipu, then leaving, like rat. Again catching, even leaving. Then after that, big fighting going on, with sword and everything. And after that, you see, all demigods coming, Brahma, Sankar, Indra, Varun, all coming. Because they are also disturbed by that Asur. They are also in problem, they want to kill that asura. They cannot kill. So now they are requesting Nrisimhadev, please, Prabhu, don't play with this asura. Kill him right now. And this way, Hiranyakashipu playing, fighting with Nrisimhadev. After that, Nrisimhadev ultimately catch. When evening time coming, catch and put on his lap. After that, he with nail, cut his bowel. All bowels coming, and like mala garland, like garland. You see, big fighting. After that, you see, Hiranyakashipu actually fighting. After that, Hiranyakashipu gone. Then all demigods, they are shouting. Again, flower. They are giving. They are drenching flower from us. Oh, Prabhu, we are well done. We are now safe. You see this way, Brahma, Shankar, everybody, they are giving prayer. But nobody dare to come in front of Nrisimhadev. They fear. Oh, this kind of dangerous. We never see Prabhu. Then they request Prahlad Maharaj, Prahlad, can you go in front of Nrisimhadev? Because Prabhu, Prabhu's incarnation is for you to save you. Can you go in front of Nrisimhadev to pacify him? Then Brahma went requesting Prahlad. Prahlad said, well, I can go. I don't fear. Then in front of Nrisimhadev, Prahlad Maharaj going, and after that he prostrated Dandavat. In front of Nrisimhadev. Small boy, 5 years, paying prostrate Dandavat. Then Nrisimhadev become very merciful. Oh, the small boy paying Dandavat, and take that boy up and put on lap. Put on lap. And after that, as heaven, giving blessing and requesting Prahlad, for you I am coming actually, you see, so you must beg some benediction from me. And anybody asking in this material world, Prabhu, we like to see a devotee, an example of your devotee. Anybody asking, then I have the chance to speak that way. You look Prahlad. Mad bhakto patirupadri tvam. You are the example among my devotees. Mad bhakto patirupadri. Now you can beg something from me, because I am Supreme Lord. I am coming in front of you. Please, you ask any kind of thing, anything you like, I can give blessing to you, benediction. Prahlad Maharaj saying, Prabhu, your blessing is very lucrative, I know. But actually I have taken bath in Asura Kula, in Asura destiny I take bath. So automatically I am Rajaguna. Prahlad Maharaj, I am out of humbleness speaking. So again you are showing me some as incentive in front of me. You are putting some. You ask some benediction. You ask some. What kind of benediction I can ask from you? You already appear in front of me. This is benediction. I don't want anything from you. Please, you want something from me. Because I come in front of you. You are not asking anything. It's not good. You must accept. Repeatedly Nrisimhadev speak, requesting Prahlad. Prahlad, you ask something. Prahlad saying, you are my master, I am your servant. So master and servant relations should be there without any self-interest. There should not be any self-interest. So our interest, our relation is very pure relation. So please, I don't want to ask anything. No, still you will have to ask something. Then Prahlad Maharaj saying, you are repeatedly asking me to take benediction well. Now, you please bless me so that no kind of desire can appear inside me. Vranang vrinishe, you take benediction from me. What kind of benediction? What kind of benediction? Prahlad Maharaj speaking, in my heart, no kind of material desire can appear. Kamanam hidi sangroho bhavatastu vinevaram. Kamanam hidi sangroho bhavatastu vinevaram. I want to get benediction from you so that no kind of desire can appear in my heart. Nishingvansi is so clever, these 5 years, what? So clever? He is asking to satisfy me. At the same time, he is very clever, you see. You asking me to take anything. So I ask, you can give blessing so that no kind of desire can appear inside me. Kamanam hidu sangroho bhavatastu vinevaram. After that, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, I don't fear your Nishingaru. Naham bibhemite ati bhayanakasyo jivhar kunetra bhakti ravaso grudanshat antas sajaho kesharo sankukarnat nirahad abhita digvadari bhinna nakhagrat Tastra asti tastra asmi aham kipana vassalo dussahogro sansara chakra gatanad gasatam panitam naham bivemite ati bhayanakasyo jivhar kunetra bhukti ravaso grudanshtat. Hey Prabhu, your Nishinga roop I don't fear, and blood spot there on your face, because when you cut the belly, then all blood coming, like spring blood coming. It's very dangerous, your room. But still I don't fear. Naham bibhemite oti bhayanakasyo jivhar kunetra bhukti ravasagradam stat antasrajah kesharau sankukarnat nirhad abhita digbhadri bhinna nakagrat trasto asmi aham kipanavassala dussahogro sansar chakra gadanad gasadam pranita. I don't fear your this Nishingaru. I don't think it is dangerous. I don't fear. But I fear this material world. Don't try to put myself in this material world. I fear this material world. It's very dangerous. Your external roof is very dangerous, but inside your heart there is love for me. Nishingadev licking Prahlad Maharaj. Nishingadev licking Prahlad Maharaj this way with love. So Prahlad Maharaj speaking, I don't fear. I know your heart. I don't fear. This way, see, Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of all. Man, all of us, so nice teaching. If I go on discussing Prahlad Maharaj teaching, 6 months I cannot finish. Whole 7 canto, I can go on discussing. But in gist, I am speaking. Now, what is the outcome of Nishinga Chaturdasi? What is the net outcome we Gauriya like to get from this Nishinga Chaturdasi? Baris, one day Prabhupada watching the Nishingadev from Nishingapalli daily coming to take Paranam Paramanna Prasadam of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati one day watching. Every day Nishingadev coming for Nishing. Though Nishingadev and Gaur same, no problem. But still Nishingadev coming to take Paramanna. Then Prabhupada become very sorry. From today I promise you, I can give special paramanu to you. I can give offer. Then deity Lakshmi Nishingo established and installed Nata, from then. So why Prabhupada worship Nishingadev? Why Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami are shouting, Jai Nishingadev, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Gurudev. Whenever any danger coming in your life, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Nishingadev, Jai Gurudev, you can speak. Guru Maharaj used to speak this. No danger can touch. First of all, Guru Maharaj speaking, Bhajana path iha kantaka ruddha, koti kantaka ruddha. Ha ha kajami ki maham karomi. This sloka I can explain. Guru Maharaj speaking, those who are in devotional line, billions of problems can come in your life. In each and every step, there is throne. In Vrindavan, you know, when you are doing parikram throne, then, if you can suffer, then you can do Bhajamandala parikrama. One throne gone, oh, I cannot do parikrama. Call one car, AC car, I can do parikrama. Then, what kind of parikrama you can do? Whereas Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Nityanandabhu, oh, they are doing barefooted. Huh? Prabhupada also? Madhava Goswami, my Guru Maharaj. Then, then you see, to cut problem. And Guru Maharaj speaking, in every state you must call Nishingadev. Please back me. I like to get some backing from Nishingadev so that no kind of problem can stand in the way of my bhajan life. So can I can go up, on and on. This way you see my Guru Maharaj speaking, always speaking. If you can call Nishingadev, then you can go ahead in bhajan. Though Nityananda Prabhu already promised us. Nityananda promised us. Nityananda Prabhu already promised us. In front of us. In front of us. I can deliver you all. Nityananda Prabhu speaking. I can deliver you all. Then, and Nishingavatar, where from Nishingavatar coming? Actually, from Krishna Balaram coming. From Balaram, first Chaturbhuha. Second Chaturbhuha. Then Mahavishnu. From Mahavishnu, all avatar beach. Brahma Sangita again. Is the seat of all avatar. So ultimately, all avatar coming from Balaram Nityananda. Be careful. And Nishingo Bhagavan, Varaha Bhagavan, Ramchandra, any avatar, they have their respective place in this Vaikuntha Jagat. They have their respective place. They have their respective place. They have their respective place in Vaikuntha Jagat. Follow. They have their respective place, Vaikuntha Jagat. Varaha Dev, Varaha Vaikuntha, Nishingadev, Nishingadev Vaikuntha. If you get Siddhi, like in Parikrama Khanda books, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, that Kuladip, that Brahman, he is worshipping Varahadev. Then one day he is saying like cloud color, Varahadev appear and bless. With tears he is stotra in Parikrama Khanda. Parikrama books you can find, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. So when that Brahman getting Siddhi, he can go to Varahadham, Varaha Vaikuntha there. Prahlad Maharaj going to Nishingadev there. Now some special point I like to discuss. What is the special point? Different sampradaya, they can fight with you. They can say, we must speak Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. They are fighting with us. Because Ram took birth before. They are fighting this way. I see, man, come on. One circle is there, if in rotating condition, I mean moving, then what is the starting point, what is the end point? One circle is there, what is the starting point? You cannot understand any starting point. Because starting point and end point are the same. Starting point and end point all same. Because it's moving. What is starting point for you? It is ending point from other. Now, if I speak, that come on, if you speak this way, then Ramchandra took birth before, but before Krishna Chandra. But now if I see, if I can speak this way, how Prahlad Maharaj can know the name of Krishna? Why Prahlad Maharaj speaking? Why Prahlad Maharaj speaking about Krishna? Motirna Krishna Paruto Satoba. I already spoke. Motirna Krishna Paruto Satoba. Mito vipadet griho vratanam. Adant govir vishatam tamisram. Panaha una charvito charvananam. Then if I ask, then Prahlad Maharaj from Satyaju. How Prahlad Maharaj speaking this way? Motirna Krishna Paruto Satoba. No. I mean Naraji told, but this conception I mean speaking, Naraji Prahlad Maharaj speaking. In front of Hiranyakashipu. Motirna Krishna Paruto Satoba. Matirna Krishna Paruto Satoba. This my material mind cannot get attachment by the effort of material people from inside or outside. No. Motirna Krishna Paruto Satoba. Or if I try myself, still I cannot get that kind of buddhi, brain, so that I can get attachment with Krishna. Not possible. Motir na Krishna Paruto Satoba. By personal effort or by the effort of outside people, nobody can get bhakti. Motirna Krishna Paruto Satoba. Mitho vipadde to grihabhatanam. They are taking vow to do lead their family life. Matirna Krishna Paruto Satoba. Mitho vipadde to grihabhatanam. Vrato prathamin vow. They have taken resolution. We like to this material life. Who are you to change my conception? Matirna Krishna Paruto Satoba. Mitho vipadde to grihabhatanam. Adanto means they have no control over their sense organ. Adanto govi vishatam tamishram. They are going down and down into tama. Tamasik guna, they are going down. Adanto, they have no control over their sense organ. Adanto govi vishatam tamishram. Vishatam means they are entering into this tamagun, narak, hell. Adanto govir visatam tamisam panaha panaha charvito charvananam. Whenever you get one stick, sabji you met, stick, sabji, you already eat, you take, then we chew, after that we throw. After chewing, you are less interested to take the residue again and chew. Already you chew and throw. Stick sabji, you chew, after that chewing done, you throw. But Prahlad Maharaj speaking, those who are material people, they are getting material enjoyment daily and every time. But still, they are not getting satisfaction. Material sense organ like to take so many things from material world. If you are going to give this material advantage, then never you can come out of this material enjoyment. You cannot come. You cannot come out successful. Never. So Prahlad Maharaj speaking, you see, they are already getting this kind of enjoyment, material enjoyment, all the time. Same enjoyment there, daily. But still, they are not developing any kind of detachment in their heart. still they are not developing any kind of detachment in their heart. Why? Punaha punaha charvito charvanam. Repeatedly they are chewing that stick, but still they are getting, they think we are getting some enjoyment. Punaha punaha charvito charvanam. And about family life, Prahladmas, kundu yena kara ribo duksha duksham. Kundu yena kara ribo duksha duksham. Material life enjoyment, Prahladmas comparing. If you have scabies, scabies you know? Don't know? Subside of. Scabies. Itching. Doctor speak, don't try to touch nail there, but you are sleeping. You are getting enjoyment? Prahlad Maharaj comparing it with material people, though the spiritual doctor they forbid, don't go for material enjoyment. Jehi sansparsa jabhogaha duksha jana evate adyanta bantya kantya nate suramate buddhaha. Krishna already giving advice you in Gita. Jehi sansparsa jabhogaha duksha jana evate adyant vantakantiyo nate suramate buddhaha. Those who are really intelligent, they never go for material enjoyment. With the help of sense organ, material sense organ, you like to enjoy all material things. Some rasa is there. Of course rasa is there, material rasa. Then why they are getting enjoyment? Rasa is there, material rasa. Sukham aindriyakam daktya. Prahladma speaking. Oh my boys, sukham aindriyakam daktya deho yogena dehinam. Sarvatra lakshya, sarvatra labhati yasmad yatha duksham ayatnata. Oh my friends, hear me. Sukham aindriyakam. Those enjoyment, material enjoyment, you can get any life. Any life you can get this kind of. Sukham aindriyakam daitya deho yogena dehinam sarvatra labhati. In any life, supposed some jivatma taking birth of a pig. Pig, you know? Pig? That pig also enjoying. Nice, nice stool. He is taking nice stool. Oh, today my life is very. Today I gave nice, nice stool, so many stool. So I have the chance to eat, to get that enjoyment. So this way, you see, nice, nice stool. So any, in any birth, any life, you can get that coming. Andhyakandhita, deho yogena dehinam, sarvatalabhadi yasmad, yatha dukkham ajatnata. And you are not trying to get pain, you are trying to get pain? You are trying? Never, nobody try to get pain. But still they are getting, according to their past deeds. So this way you cannot save yourself. So anyway, it is the advice of Prahlad Maharaj, you will have to do Krishna bhajan anyway. So he is speaking the name of Krishna, Satyaju. So how then Prahladma is speaking about Krishna? So this is not, your argument is not good. Those Ramanandi Sampadaya, this the other some, they are fighting. Krishna, Ramchandra took birth before, so he must speak about Ram. First question is Ram, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, this Ram is not Ram, not Dasati Ram. It's Krishna himself, Ramanath Ram. He is enjoying with Radharani, that's why Ram. Ramanath. That's why. So they are all the way they are wrong. Explaining wrong way. So this way I can go on discussing this point long and long time. But I have so many seva to go to do seva. That's why I beg for pardon to you all. This way, if you have any question, I can answer. Now I like to stop. Vancha kalpataroshi ke basind bhavajapati thanang papane bhavishnaya bhyo namo. Jai Prahlad Maharaj ki jai. Jai Nisingadev Bhagwan ki jai. Jai Jai Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Jai Guru Varga ki jai. Gaur Pramanande. You have any question? No question. I already answer. Huh?
I didn't understand. You said that special teaching, and then you said Prahlad Maharaj. How can Prahlad Maharaj talk about Krishna Chaitanya?
Huh?
You said how can Prahlad Maharaj talks about Krishna Chaitanya? But I didn't understand how.
Huh?
Just asking how Prahlad Maharaj could speak about Krishna in Satya Yuga.
Actually, Prahlad Maharaj is Mahajan. Prahlad Maharaj having full conception of the spiritual world. Prahlad Maharaj is not foolish like ordinary people, so that Prahlad Maharaj can say this Krishna is the topic of Dwapar Yuga. Because Prahlad Maharaj knowing the Krishna avatar is Nitya. Nitya, Nishinga avatar is also Nitya. That's why Prahlad Maharaj can see. Prahlad Maharaj, no, Nishinga avatar is Krishna avatar. Krishna is Nishinga. Ultimately, Krishna is taking the form. And in Gaurdham, we have extra facility that there Nishingapalli. What is this place? When Hiranyakasipu was killed by Nishingadev, after Nishingadev took rest there. That is a special place. And special thing is that our this goal, that Nishingadev is Gaur Nishinga. Gaur Nishinga. Atat Gauranga Mahaprabhu took the form of Nishinga. A special. Sometime you offer Bhoga, we can say, hey, Gaur Nishingaya Namaha. Then okay. Gaur Nishingaya Namaha. I like to worship Krishna. I mean, Gaur. By the same Nishinga special avatar today. So Gaur Nishingaya Namaha. Done? This way. Okay. Done? Okay? Then? Chal, so. Beta.
Maharaj, another question. You said that we can develop capacity of reach what the Vaishnavas are saying. Number one, Brahmacharya. Then, number two,
Guru Vaishnava Seva. Brahmacharya, it automatically implies. Brahmacharya automatically implies that Guru Seva, together with Guru Seva. Brahmacharya doesn't mean as a dry thing. I can do some exercise with barbell to get my muscle up. Papa speaking this way. It's not one kind of exercise. I am doing it barber to get my muscle up. Yes, I mean, come on. Brahmacharya means automatically Guru Seva. Sadguru Seva is pure meaning. Then you can get power, to realization power. Extraordinary power you can get through Brahmacharya. It's one kind of backing. Bhakti is nirapekha. Doesn't mean Brahmacharya you are playing, so you can get bhakti, not that. So that's why to Suklambar Brahmachari Mahaprabhu is speaking. Do you think you are drinking milk, you are doing astringent because you can get me? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking in front of Suklambar Brahmachari. You are drinking milk only. Do you think by this procedure you can get me? Not that. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, behind everything, serving meat should be there, bhakti should be there. Bhakti is the beginning, bhakti is the end. Bhakti in the middle. Everywhere, anywhere you look, bhakti. Without bhakti, nothing. So, out of Nishinga Jyotasi, we like to protect our pure devotion so that we can go up and up. Go up and up unto lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We Gaudiyas have the special facility to do bhajan. We are doing bhajan of Radha Krishna. But we keep Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in front. Anywhere you see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there, Radha Krishna there. So through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we like to look at Krishna through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Through, it's a transparent media. Why we put Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in front of Radha Krishna? What it means? It means, first of all, you must call Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then in Gaur Lila, if you can get entry, automatically you can get it, Radha Govinda Lila. You should not jump. Gaur Lila and Krishna Lila oriented. when you get Vastu Siddhi, you can get double benefit. I can discuss this point up. So any question more? Vanchakalpa Durvasu.
It's not only remembering, it is also important to get the samskara.
Uh-huh.
Samskara is more
important. Samskara is more important.
It's not,
Yes.
That will stay with you.
Uh-huh. Yes.